Okay. Good. Sorry that I cannot come to the campus today, but I am physically in Berkeley. So today I'm going to talk about implicit regularization in deep learning. Well, let me just start by briefly reviewing the pipeline of deep learning. So usually we first need to have a data set. So for example, ImageNet is the one of the most popular. And then we need to design a model. And in the context of deep learning, the model is usually in the form of a deep neural network. And there are usually many, many parameters in the model. And we want to find a configuration of these parameters such that the model can perform well on the data population. And the way to find such parameters is to try to minimize some loss function, some training loss function, which basically measures how well the model performs on the training data set. And in practice, the loss is usually minimized by the gradient descent algorithm or some variants of the gradient descent algorithm. And this pipeline has achieved tremendous success in practice, which is very mysterious from a theoretical perspective. And one of the biggest mysteries in the theory of deep learning is the so-called generalization mystery. That is, over-parameterized neural networks can generalize well, meaning that they not only can fit the training samples, but also perform well on unseen test samples. So let me use a simple example to illustrate this. Let's say that this is our training data set with images of cats and dogs. And when we train a neural net to classify this data set, the neural net could learn this blue boundary, for example. But because the model is usually highly overparameterized, it is also capable of representing very complicated functions. For example, this red boundary, which looks very different from the blue one. But these two solutions perform equally well on the training data set. So they both have zero training error, but they may perform very differently on new test samples because these two are very different functions. So that means even if we successfully solve the optimization problem and get small training error, that doesn't imply we will have generalization. We will have small test error because in principle, we don't know whether we found the blue solution or the red solution if we just look at the training error. But in practice, just by minimizing the training loss using gradient descent-like algorithms, we can somehow often find solutions that generalize well to test samples. And this is the mystery that's not well understood. And what is believed to be an explanation of this behavior is that there's an implicit regularization effect from the optimization algorithms we use. So the main proposal is that the optimization algorithms such as gradient descent or stochastic gradient descent prefers low complexity solutions. So even if the whole model space is very complex, gradient descent will only find certain low complexity solutions for some reason. And that, if that's true, that would imply good generalization performance. So I'm gonna present two simple deep learning examples where we are able to mathematically characterize the implicit regularization going on there. So the first one is for linear networks and the second is for nonlinear networks. So let me go into the first example. So for this example, we will consider this classical problem of matrix completion. So the goal of matrix completion is to recover a low rank matrix given only a subset of its entries. And this is a well-studied problem in machine learning and statistics. And the typical application is in recommendation systems. So think about predicting user ratings, but given only a subset of the ratings. So today for simplicity, we'll just assume that this ground truth matrix, which I call M, is a square matrix. So it's a D by D matrix and it has low rank. So how do you solve this problem? So first we can easily write down a naive training loss, which looks like this. So we try to find a matrix W, which is our model that minimizes this training loss over the observed entries. And of course, many optima exist for this problem because we can just assign any values to the unobserved entries. So there's no hope of recovering the true matrix M using this naive approach. But that's simply because we haven't used the assumption that the matrix should be low rank. So we may want to add some explicit regularization to encourage low rank. And the classical approach is to add a nuclear norm regularization like this. So recall that nuclear norm is the sum of all the singular values of a matrix, which can be viewed as a convex relaxation of the rank. But what we are considering today is a different and a counterintuitive approach, which I call a deep learning approach. So what we do here is to try to find this matrix M as a product of multiple matrices. And in the language of deep learning, this can be viewed as a deep linear network because it's parameterized as a product of L matrices W1 through WL, which is a composition of L layers of linear transformations. So here's the objective function corresponding to this approach. And so it's a function of these L matrices W1 through WL. And notice that here I'm requiring all these matrices to have to be sized D by D. So we are by doing this, we are not imposing any constraint on the rank of the matrix. And actually it's very easy to see that this problem is exactly the same as the problem in this naive method, because we can still express all the D by D matrices using the product of multiple D by D matrices. So it seems that doing this reparameterization doesn't make much sense, and we wouldn't expect this to be useful at all. But the surprise is that empirically, if we just minimize this new objective using gradient descent with initialization close to zero, we can almost always recover the ground truth matrix M accurately. And this is surprising because we are not explicitly asking for a low rank solution in the objective. So the only possibility is that the optimization algorithm we use, which is gradient descent in this case, has an implicit regularization that somehow can help us find the low rank ground truth matrix. And this implicit regularization effect, we can understand it by analyzing the dynamics of the gradient descent algorithm in this problem. And an important step in the analysis is to derive the dynamics of the singular values of the solution matrix, which is this equation. And from this equation, we can see that the depth, the number of layers, L, affects this dynamics via this blue factor. And we can interpret it as inducing a rich get richer phenomenon among different singular values, which encourages low rank because different singular values will grow at very different rates according to this equation. And we can verify this intuition by plotting the evolution of all the singular values during the course of gradient descent. Okay, so basically for this problem, we had a very nice mental picture of how the gradient descent algorithm prefers low complexity solutions. And the appropriate notion of complexity here is the rank of the solution matrix. And we can divide the space of all the solutions according to their rank. And our ground truth matrix might be here, which is a low rank global minimum of the loss function. But there are also many other global minima which have higher rank, and they all have zero training loss. So what happens when we run gradient descent starting close to zero is that it will first search over the rank one spaces, and then the rank two, rank three, and eventually it will settle down at a low rank minimum. So it will never reach these higher rank spaces, so it won't go to all those non-generalizable minima. And this is done implicitly by running gradient descent. So we can view this dynamic picture as indicating a more general statement that maybe neural network learns functions of increasing complexity during training. And the notion of the complexity in this example was the rank of the matrix. And this general hypothesis is to believe to be perhaps true in some sense, but in general, we still don't know what is the right way to characterize the complexity of neural networks. And especially in nonlinear deep neural networks, this becomes much more challenging than linear networks. And next I'm gonna very briefly talk about another interesting theoretical result along the lines of this general hypothesis. And in particular, we will show that in some natural settings, a nonlinear network trained by gradient descent only learns a linear function first before it starts to learn anything else. And so the formal result is for a standard two-layer neural network trained by gradient descent. So the network looks like this. So it has two layers and there's nonlinearity in the hidden layer of the network. And we also consider a hypothetical process, which is a linear model also trained by gradient descent. So it's just a simple linear model on the input X. So the beta one and beta two here are the parameters in this linear model. And what we prove is that these two processes can be coupled. And specifically, in the early time of running gradient descent, the neural network and the linear model compute almost the same function for input X coming from the underlying data distribution. So that means, although the neural network has nonlinear capacity, when we are running gradient descent, it will implicitly bias the neural network towards a simple linear function at the beginning of training. So this is also a very interesting implicit regularization effect. So here are some experiments to verify this result. So basically, these plots are showing that the neural network and the hypothetical linear model basically behave the same in the early time of gradient descent, which verifies this theorem. Okay, so to conclude, I argued that the implicit regularization effect from the optimization algorithms is key to understanding the generalization behavior in modern deep learning, and I presented two case studies where we are able to show exactly how neural network learns functions of increasing complexity during the course of gradient descent. And these examples also show that perhaps analyzing the dynamics of the learning procedure may be important to understand, or even just to describe the implicit regularization effect in deep learning. Okay, that's the end of my talk, and feel free to get in touch if you are interested in chatting about deep learning. Thanks.
We'll move to Manolis now. So I just had us in a chat. Manolis, do you hear me?
Yep, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes. Every-